What's the difference between this? So, excusing my renditions, how did they differ? Well, one is a style more often evoked when covering that seminal recording, not that there's anything wrong with that, but what else? There's a significant difference in tone, gratuitous use of reverb, one is swung a bit more than the other, and also rakes feature more prominently in the first example. If you guess what I'm getting at has something to do with the thumb, give yourself a prize. Jimi employed his thumb in a multitude of ways while playing, from Wes Montgomery-style octaves to playing percussively, like in the Machine Gun intro, to reaching over the neck to play bass notes, freeing up his other fingers for embellishments, and also in the way we're going to look at in this video, which he no doubt picked up from an R&B hero of his. Jimi spent his formative years on the Chitlin' circuit and took in a wealth of performance mastery from numerous legends, but one artist in particular stood out, as he recalled. The best gig was with Curtis Mayfield and the Impressions. Curtis was a really good guitarist. I learned a lot in that short time. He probably influenced me more than anyone I'd ever played with up to that time, that sweet sound of his. Curtis's melodic flourishes and fills while playing rhythm were characterized by a distinct choking staccato of the string with the picking hand thumb. This resulted in a percussive, subtle pinch harmonic, giving the pick attack a higher fundamental frequency because of the nodes of the now shorter vibrating string. Jimi Hendrix executed this expertly in his rhythm playing, but also used the technique in his single note soloing. This can be heard to beautiful effect all over the Electric Ladyland album, from the title track to the solo on All Along the Watchtower. Okay, so how do we execute this? If you can do this, then you've already got a pretty good head start. Because as I mentioned earlier, these are essentially pinch harmonics. You're gonna take the pick and choke up on it with your thumb and allow the fleshy part right here to bounce off the string after plucking it. Try to do this around the neck pickup area, or you can even venture over the fretboard. A good riff to practice this with is the quintessential Castles Made of Sand. Which sounds like this. This beautiful technique can be found throughout the entirety of the Hendrix catalog, so once you get it under your thumb, try applying it to some other of your favorite riffs. Thank you. Thanks for watching, and if you got anything out of this, consider hitting the like button or possibly even sharing it with a fellow Hendrix fan. Peace out.
No, I can't see either of your hands. Yeah, but you can't see anything.
Okay, here we go. Sit.
Okay, I'm recording.